Tom, good morning, buddy. We'll start with the LSU loss. I mean, there's areas you can point to. Arkansas didn't shoot the ball that great, 42%. But to me, the free throws, man, 58% from the free throw line, including some uncharacteristic misses from Moses Moody. What would you say was the biggest difference in that LSU game on Saturday?
Yeah, good morning, everybody. I said on this air that I thought them playing in back-to-back-to-back games would be good, but they didn't look like a real energetic team. They looked a little bit slow in the second half. I thought the ball movement was not real good in the second half when LSU really got up and played defense on them. And I think missing free throws is an outgrowth of not having a ton of energy sometimes, you know, not getting the leg bend and all that, the knee bend you need when you take a regular free throw. So that was a little surprising to me. And we've just got to hope that Jalen Tate plays better, that Deji Sills can give them more better minutes, that Connor Vanover can give them minutes, and Jalen Williams can come back. And, you know, when they're a complete team and they can go deep on their bench, I don't think we'll see a lull like that in terms of the energy level.
Tom, you brought up Jalen Williams. That's something Eric Musselman was asked about. I think Bob was asking about Jalen's status, and he said he'll be back, and in reference to the NCAA tournament. Do you think that game would have turned out different if Jalen Williams would have been a go?
Well, it would have just been different because if he's in there, you know, the minutes get distributed differently. And he's when he hit his stride late in the SEC season, you saw all the things he can do. I mean, he's not a ball stopper. He handles the ball pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
He takes a good mid-range shot. He draws some fouls. And what a defender he is. So there's so many advantages to having him on the court that we're going to see, hopefully, in this NCAA tournament.
We're talking with Tom Murphy, talking Arkansas baseball, basketball with Tom. Tom, I tried to hop on the Zoom press conference and selection show announcement for Arkansas yesterday in the car driving home, but the LTE from AT&T wasn't having it, so I had to watch it late last night. There was a lot of excitement from this basketball team, and you think about Deji Sills, this will be his first tournament game. It was an expectation and a goal for Moses Moody, and we were talking with Clay earlier. Muss went from looking like someone was just one of the angriest I've seen Muss in a while to just happy as a clam yesterday. It's wild how, and obviously a day, and then just the excitement surrounding that can be. Just your thoughts on Arkansas being selected as the highest 3 seed in the NCAA tournament.
Well, that winning streak, that 11 games in the SEC was just a phenomenal deal. It put them where they are. And it just goes to show that when they're hitting on all cylinders, when they're defending better, they can be a great team. And you saw the emotion in a Jalen Tate, who had been there a few times with Northern Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
But now he's kind of like a veteran leader on a team. And Justin Smith just feeling, you know, validating his decision to come here. And Eric Musselman talked about how both his parents are super happy that he made this choice, and they're in the position they're in. And then, of course, Deji Sills is the first tournament. So a lot of happiness in Razorback town. But I'll tell you, this Colgate team looks dangerous. And
yep,
their stats are all built up against 5 Patriot League teams. But they're used to winning. They're confident in what they do. And Arkansas is going to have superior athleticism on them, and to me, that's the thing you have to take advantage of the most. Is you're more athletic. You know, your guys can jump higher. You have faster guys on the hole. They've got to drive the ball in this game. Drive the ball, draw fouls, and it's not going to be an easy out. Colgate played Tennessee tough 2 years ago. I think it was a 7-point game, but they were in the game.
Yep.
And listening to their top player, they are very confident that they can come in and get a win in the NCAA tournament.
And how about Ruda? like Coach Ruda predicting who the team was going to be that Arkansas was going to play. I thought that was a pretty wild tid from Eric Musselman yesterday. Tom, you mentioned kind of validation from Justin Smith and Moses Booty, and me and Claire are going to ask you some football question. I'll ask you a baseball question coming up, and final basketball question. Not only the validation from Justin transferring in, it's a highly coveted guy, had a lot of different places he could have gone. Well, I think his performance and what he's been to this basketball team has really just been a validation for this Arkansas basketball program. And then flip the script, you got a true freshman in Moses Moody, the highest recruit on this basketball team, and based on how where he's projected right now, based on how he's been used this year, would you say that Arkansas based on those two guys can appeal to both transfers and high value true freshman recruits on those two individuals?
There's a lot of recruiting advantage that Arkansas got from this year. That he can put together a roster composed of all kind of different, you know, transfers, freshmen, guys get injured, playing guys in different ways. Yeah, I think, and just the way they communicate with their players, I think this season is just the recruiting poster for Arkansas and how he handled a team and how they've stayed together even when your minutes differ. You know, I mean, Devo Davis wasn't playing a ton early on, and look how he's come on. So yeah, big time recruiting pitches can be made, and you know, we can talk more about the Colgate matchup coming up because there's a lot of good stuff about those guys.
Go ahead, Clay.
Well, first of all, I was going to kind of stick with basketball and go with something that you said, Tom, about energy. And I just wondered what you thought of J.D. Notte. And he just wasn't the Energizer Bunny like he was. And whether that food poison or whatever it was, you know, might have been a factor in that second day.
You know, I think so. I read something years ago about athletes who are sick. And I think it pertained to golf maybe more than any other sport. But it could apply. A lot of times when you're sick, that first game, you feel like, well, I'm going to overcome this, and you play beyond yourself a little. And J.D. Notte clearly did that. He has not had a shooting game like that in so long. And then game two, you're riding that confidence, and you just feel like your shot's going to keep going. And he takes his shot, no matter how he's feeling. He takes his shot. They just weren't happening against LSU, and maybe it falls into that study that I read years ago.
It makes sense to me, and it sure looked like he was a different guy that second day. Football, in you know, we get to see a little, you know, I call it a snapshot. You know, it's not, you know, getting to see all the way up to team practice is great, but it's still not, you know, you know you missed the most important part of practice, which it's by design. That's the part they don't want you to see. They want you to see the offense, the splits, and you know, I know why the media is asked to leave at that point, you know, after the individual drills are over. My thought is the most important thing that's happened in this spring is the quarterback play. And I, you know, we like KJ Jefferson, but what did you think of Hornsby and Coley? And because I think that's the real battle, because they're, if you tackle quarterbacks in the fall, there's going to be a time when the number one's hurt and you're going to be stuck with number two for maybe a couple of games. So what did you think about that battle?
Well, obviously we want to see a lot more before we can make, like, definitive declarations. But I like Coley's athleticism. And, Clay, I was writing something down, and I looked up because I was trying to watch all the quarterback passes. And when my eyes came back to the field, all I saw was I was looking straight down a pass. And it was a beautiful, tight spiral from Hornsby to whoever he was throwing it to. And it was just right in perfect position to catch, right into the body. And I know this wasn't against the defense or anything, but just the ball itself, just the delivery, was gorgeous. So one thing that Sam Pittman said on our opening Zoom with him to lead into the spring, I asked him about how having KJ and Malik Hornsby as your, you know, top two contenders at quarterback can fit into what Kendall does. And Sam's response was this. Last year, Kendall Briles basically had to tweak some of the stuff he did to fit Felipe. And now these guys, running quarterbacks, fit more into Kendall's, you know, wheelhouse. So he can expand on things he wants to do based on their talent. And so I just think it's a great marriage. This style of quarterback, dual threat, is what Kendall Briles wants to do offensively. And you just have to maximize the things you feel like you can do with them this spring.
All three of them, I think, fit. I think you're right. I think Coley is definitely a fit. And he's a little bigger than Hornsby's. Not as big as KJ, but all three of them have got wheels. And to me, it looks like they have the ability to cut. And I think Franks was just a straight line guy. I mean, straight line looking for a place to fall. And I don't mean that in a bad way.
No, Clay, I tell you, I probably laughed out loud five or six times, well, almost maybe once a game when Felipe was scrambling, because he's got those tall legs and it's hard to cut on a dime, and he dove forward so often. Not to belittle Felipe, he was a decent scrambler, and Sam Pittman called him a surprising runner or something like that.
No, that's what I said.
But it was fun to see Felipe in action, and I do think these guys are going to tuck it and run it and get downfield a lot more often than Felipe did, because I think Felipe took a few sacks and had some late bolts from the pocket that were not super productive, mm-hmm. whereas these guys, I think, are going to get some more yards there.
Tom, appreciate it, buddy. We'll talk Thursday, get a little more in-depth of preview of Colgate.
Yeah, baseball too. Good talk to you guys. See you.
Right. Later, buddy.